If I had eyes in the back of my head, I would have told you that you look good as I walked away.
Almost every record I go into it hoping it feels like a whole unit. And they always have, like, sonically, I think they've always kind of felt like the songs all fit together in a nice sequence. And thematically, they jump around a bit. This one, the songs tie together really nice in my mind. It has sort of a nice cinematic ride through the whole thing.
Who needs please when we've got guns? Who needs peace when we've gone above? But beyond where we should have gone, we went beyond where we should have gone.
The interesting thing about this record is there's more electric on it, but there's also more songs that are just voice and acoustic than any other record I've done.
She gives me presents with a presence alone. She gives me everything I could wish for. She gives me kisses on the lips just for coming home.
And that's something JP and I discussed. He kind of wanted to make it not 4 to 6 feet and glassy. He wanted to make it like a couple of 1 foot sort of longboard days and a couple of 20 foot, not quite towing in, but like big paddling days, and some days it's stormy. Try to make it a little more dynamic.
Go on, just go on. We're bound by blood that's moving from the moment that we start.
Recording a tape was one of the major things because it affects the actual way that it's sounding, but it also limits what we can do in the studio. It's like we got 24 tracks. You can't just keep pushing file, new track, you know, the Pro Tools. A lot of the stuff that would bug me right after we do a take, a week later I would forget about it completely. I wouldn't even hear that anymore. It changes the sound in that way, I think.
You might think I'm your enemy, but that don't make you mine. All I have now is a movie. Wish that you'd stop trying. Oh, please stop lying.
The studio, the being that it runs off solar power, and it's like all the wood that we use in here was reclaimed lumber, it just feels better. I mean, it feels nice every time you look at that, just to think about our Australian friend Luke coming in here and stripping that wood and building those things. It's like feels more homemade anyways, and you know, just doing as many things as you can, low impact. That's one thing we do before. And then once you're in here, though, like I was saying, it feels better to be in here. But it's not like we make music because we have a solar power studio. We make music because there's things to talk about in life, and there's songs you want to write. And so we get in here and we do that. Thing runs just normal, and it's great. And it sure feels good to be able to tell kids and stuff and to promote that. You know, that you can decide you want to do something different. Don't think you just have to kind of become on this pattern that somebody else has set up for you. So even if it's not like environmental stuff, but just showing people that you can kind of go off and do your own thing.
I can't give you everything you want. I could give you what you got you need.
I'll meet a lot of people after the show that'll say, I got your first record when I was 14 years old. And it's just such a weird trip to think that, you know, it's nice to think somebody can stick with it and not grow out of it. It's kind of fun to have a relationship with listeners and vice versa, where you can keep writing songs for every point in that person's life. Hopefully there will be people who kind of enjoy having that parallel thing happen with the song. Going into it, it was pretty comfortable. I didn't feel like I had anything to prove. Everything's kind of got its peaks and valleys and stuff. And to me, this thing has been going on for a while. Kind of each record has kind of surprised me that it keeps sort of going in that direction. I feel like what an amazing ride it was to get to kind of keep putting out records. So if I can just keep on doing this at some level, I'm pretty happy.
Sometimes time doesn't heal. No, not